small opportunities are often the beginning of great achievements. Good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters, and welcome, guests.
Good afternoon.
I am Pranati, standing here to tell you the story of my life, but in Swiss use version. I grew up in the holy land of Lord Jagannath, named as Puri. It is one of the Chardham of Hindus. This place is one of the fascinating littoral districts of Odisha. The culture here is flourished with its manifold activities. In this beautiful and holy city, I have my home, which is very carefully maintained by my mom with lots of love and affection. My father is a very strict, disciplined and fitness-loving person who gave me the greatest gift anyone could give to another person, that is, he believed in me. My mom is a superwoman who brought me up in such a way that now I am quite able to face every challenge in my life with all positivity. My loving and crazy younger brother is now working in a bank. My younger sister, who is very sweet and very simple, makes total opposite to me, as you can notice it, is now working as a teacher in a school. As the eldest child in the family, I was always told about family values, responsibilities and many more things. Coming to my school days, which were the best and colorful years of my life. As a student, I was pretty good and much pampered by my teachers than my parents. I have a big friend circle in school with whom I had lots of fun. I was the head of that gang and used to give all the naughty ideas to them. You won't believe, they used to listen to me also. From the beginning of my school days, I was much more involved in extracurricular activities. Except one activity. Can you guess what is that?
Studying.
Studies.
No, debate competition. That was my biggest nightmare. Among all the curricular activities, dance was my all-time favorite, as he said. I learned Odissi dance, for which I got the opportunity to perform and own many hours at many places. Apart from that, I was also very much active in Red Cross and Scout Guide. From my childhood, I had dreamed of being a doctor and a great dancer. Then gradually it changed and I wanted to be a fashion designer. Again it changed and I wanted to be an engineer. Whenever I watch any movie and one of the characters is very good, I just wanted to be like that. It means I was a dreamer, I am a dreamer, and till date I dream of being on the top of the world. Because I know if you can dream it, then you can do it. So, with all those dreams in my eyes, I entered into my college days. I completed my graduation with mathematics honors. I think the subject which some of the people dislike. Am I correct? But I like the subject. After graduation, I did my MCA degree, where I got a great chance to meet Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. After a few minutes of discussion with him personally, I learned so many important aspects which helped me to motivate in my studies and life. While I was pursuing my MCA in second year, I had a turning point in my life. There was a campus selection going on for our seniors. I just attended that for my experience. Can you guess what happened? Yes, I got selected. Now, it's the toughest time for toughest decision. Because I was in only second year. And they told me to join immediately. I asked my parents and they replied, it's always what you want to do. Then, I saw my father's face and decided to do that job. Because I knew it was my father's dream and also the first opportunity to start my career. So I grabbed that chance and joined as a lecturer in an engineering college. Initially, it was a very difficult task. But gradually, because of my students, I started enjoying my job. Along with that job, I completed my MCDT. Then immediately after that, I completed my MTech in Computer Science. So for those 3 years, continuously, I was like a multitasker. Then, in 2012, one of my dreams came true. Can you guess what is that? I got married to Mr. Ravindra after 13 years of courtship. Yes, we took our friendship into a very beautiful path of life. Then, in 2014, I left my teaching job and came to Bangalore to settle down with my husband and start a new career. So, I'm here. I joined Oracle in August 2015. Immediately after joining Oracle, I came to know about Toastmasters. Despite being a lecturer, public speaking is altogether a different game to me. So, I must say, this is the great venue to improve my own speaking ability and hope to use this opportunity to learn from you all and your vast experience. And dream of being a better speaker as well. Over to you, Toastmasters.